Hello friends, today we will be discussing about the remaining four aspects of recreational therapy. First, let's look into the types of recreational activities. The first one is motor forms, basically meant to utilize the motor capabilities of the individuals. This is further classified into fundamental forms, which include games like hockey and football, and accessory form like play activity and dancing. The second form is the sensory form, wherein we enable the clients to utilize their senses. It can be either be visual, like looking at motion pictures, or can be auditory, like listening to a concert. The third one is the intellectual form. In intellectual form, we basically target in the utilization of clients' cognitive abilities, and that can include activities like reading, debating, etc. Apart from this, there are other activities that include activities for psychosexual expression, for expression of love and tenderness, for expression of muscular strength, and to increase the sensory power. Now let's look into the type of activities that can be selected for mentally ill clients in recreational therapy. For schizophrenic clients, we can include activities like shopping, dancing, etc. For excited clients, they can be engaged in function hall arrangement or visiting natural scenes. Clients suffering from anxiety can be involved in listening to melodious music, walking, etc. Individuals suffering from OCD can be involved in prayer activities or decoration of rooms. Clients from substance abuse should be involved in enactment in dramas to express themselves. And individuals suffering from depressive disorders should be engaged in non-competitive sports, wherein we provide an outlet for anger like jogging, walking, etc. For clients with dementia, they can be involved in concrete repetitious craft, wherein they are familiarized with the content. Individuals suffering from childhood and adolescent disorders, in which children can be involved in playing, storytelling, etc., whereas the adolescents who fare better in groups can be provided with gross motor activities like sports and games, wherein they can use up their excess energy. Looking into clients who are suffering from mental retardation, while giving them activities, we have to always organize the activities according to the client's level of functioning. And like, we can provide activities such as walking, dancing, etc. Now, let's see the role of a nurse in recreational therapy. Always, we have to plan the recreational activities based on the ability, talent, need, age, gender, and illness of the individual. Always encourage them to participate. Teach them the necessary skills that are required to participate in an activity. Always avoid competitive games because they can trigger their psychiatric condition. Encourage them to express themselves. Always supervise activities. Never leave the clients alone. And if any problem arises, analyze the situation and provide with proper interventions. And always appreciate the effective performance of clients. Now, when you as a nurse are planning to conduct a recreational therapy, what are the points that should be kept in mind to conduct a recreational therapy? There are mainly three points on which we have to focus while organizing a recreational therapy. The first one is to provide a non-threatening and non-demanding environment. And the second one is to provide activities that are relaxing and activities without any rigid guidelines or time frames, because that can trigger them into developing symptoms of their psychiatric conditions. And always make sure you provide activities that are enjoyable and self-satisfying. So these are the points to be kept in mind. So in today's session, we had dealt with the types of recreational activities, the selection of type of activities for mentally ill patients, role of a nurse in recreational therapy, and the points to be kept in mind while organizing a recreational therapy. Hope you all understood what is recreational therapy and its different aspects. Thank you.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magazine videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.